During your presentation, you said data warehouse is much expensive, while Hadoop is not. How EMC is working on that?
So EMC is working on replacing a lot of the concepts around the data warehouse, and instead of moving data into a proprietary system, you move that data into an open and flexible system, and that's, we call that the data lake. So a data lake is really an architecture that first of all allows you to bring data in and store it in a very efficient manner, and efficient meaning the raw format that it was originally created in. We do things like transformations in the data lake, but the key difference between maybe Hadoop, Splunk, or any of the other tools that are out there that that claim to be a data lake is that we allow all of those tools to be used. So instead of moving your data into a tool where you're providing more value to that tool and ultimately driving the cost up on that tool, you're putting your data into a centralized architecture where tools attach to the data, and now any tool can use that data at any time. That allows your data scientists to choose whatever they want to use, how they want to use it. You have people that may be only trained in SQL and may be able to use the data in SQL, but they won't necessarily know how to program in PIG. And so as they choose different tools to consume the content, the data lake's goal is to maintain open and flexible business management so that you can continue to evolve the organization and your data and by using your data.
When you move data into two, you get value, but tools are constantly changing. Is data lake the answer of EMC for this?
Yes, it is. So in a data lake, let's take Splunk as a great example. Splunk was early in to the organization into big data, and so people were bringing information in and indexing that data. Now, Splunk is good about creating a raw format of that data as well, but there's new tools out competing with Splunk, specifically Elk, which is the Elasticsearch Logstash and Kibana kits that can be used to, and oftentimes to compete with Splunk. There's newer, smaller companies such as X15 that are also going after that market. If you put that data, though, into the index and you store it into that proprietary format, then later on you're having to transition your data and you no longer have the historical context because it's in that proprietary format. It's the same with an EDW, and we've got a good relationship with Teradata, and of course customers are using things like Netezza and et cetera for their EDW, but when you put information into that, it becomes locked into that particular format. Data Lake is all about keeping the information open and raw and flexible so that you can put any tool against that information without having to choose that tool today. And as tools evolve, new tools come out. For example, Flink is looking interesting. Spark just recently became very interesting. We want to make it so that all of those tools you can bring to the data lake and consume the information without having to put the data into a proprietary format.
And can you give us an overview about data lake adoption, especially in Brazil or in Latin America region?
So data lakes globally, we've seen many hundreds of customers begin their data lake journey. We have in EMC about 800. My estimates would be that a little bit less than 100 of those are in the Latin American market, probably even less than that in the Brazilian market. I think it's a new concept that's just come out in the last 12 months. And I think that as people have seen it, they understand it, they're already starting to create that journey and start moving and making that work. I think that Brazil seems to be just behind a little bit on adoption. They like to see someone else do it first. So I would expect over the next 12 months to see an increased adoption of data lakes in this region.
Which industries do you think will push this adoption?
So if it follows the trends that we've seen in the United States and other places in the world, we see adoption in the telecommunications market first. We see it in the banking markets. Then we start to see it in some of the manufacturing markets and retail. I think other markets are slower to adopt, especially the federal markets or governments. It really depends on the region, but I think that there are certain data sets that are perfect for a data lake, perfect for big data. Call detail records and a telecommunications provider is a clear and obvious one. Credit cards swipe transactions for banking is another one. Everyone seems to be wanting to deal with fraud analytics, and I think that's a good way to start. We're also seeing things like taxation problems where people are having to figure out how they pay their taxes based on potentially where a card was swiped. And so those really hard problems to solve, really hard questions to answer, we're seeing data lakes along with attached different tools, depending on what the customer's choices, being used against that particular solution.